Lord, I want more of your goodness.
Holy, potent one, I worship you, your majesty is forevermore. Glorious God, wonderful God, miracle worker, King of kings, omnipotent one, I worship you. Your majesty is forevermore. Omnipotent one, I worship you. Your majesty is forevermore. Leave me, Lord, lead me, Lord, I will go. You have called me, I will answer. Lead me, Lord, I will go.
Shall we be on our feet? I pray in the name of Jesus, as you are in here today, I want you to open up your mouth. Everything you came for, to this place for, make the Lord hear your prayer. Let the Lord answer you. Every problem you move from your heart to this place, may the good Lord pay you sevenfold in the name of Jesus. Every problem in your education, every problem in your marriage, every problem in your workplace, you brought to this place. I pray in the name of Jesus, as the word of the Lord comes tonight, may you be spiritually minded, may you prepare your spirit, and receive the food of the Lord, and receive the food of the Spirit. As the word of the Lord comes tonight, it is not for the flesh, it is not for the flesh, neither is it for the enemy, for the word of the Lord is as poison to the enemy, but the word of the Lord is food to you. Today, the word of the Lord is food to your spirit. I pray in the name of Jesus, as the word of the Lord comes tonight, may you open up your spirit, may you open up your spirit to consume, to eat the word of the Lord. Tonight I did not come for the ones that are gentle. I came for the ones that are crazy in Christ. I came for the ones that are serious. I came for the ones that are ready to have a genuine Christ. I came for the ones that are ready to imitate Christ. I came for the ones that are ready to have a relationship with Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus, tonight you will not live here the same. Tonight you will not live here the same. In the name of Jesus. Every power of the enemy in your way, in your way, every power of stagnation, every power of whoosop that is causing you to sway away from the ways of the Lord, you that power expire now. In the name of Jesus, as you have entered this place, you have not entered an ordinary place. For the glory, for the power of the living God is in here. As you have entered the spiritual hospital and the spiritual clinic, whatsoever you brought to this place, I pray in the name of Jesus, it shall be answered. I pray for the power of the Holy Ghost. May the fire in you be activated. May the fire in you be be ignited high in the name of Jesus. Tonight, the word of the Lord is not for those ones that came here to be gentle, but I want you to open up your mouth and pray to the Lord. Maybe the past 4 months, maybe the past 3 weeks, maybe the past days, there is something in your heart. There is something you have been asking for. You have been saying, Father Lord, why me? Father Lord, why me? Father, I want to have a deeper relationship with you. But it seems as though there is a magnetic pull from the other side, pulling me away from you. Tonight, I pray in the name of Jesus. I activate the word of the Lord in your life. As the word of the Lord says, draw nearer to me, and I shall draw near to you. Tonight you shall draw near to the Lord. Tonight you shall draw near to the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Have your seat. Mama Katu Shata. Tonight I'll be talking to you, so I want you to also talk back to me. Tonight, I'm not like a lion to you, I'm like your best friend. So when the Spirit of the Lord speaks anything and it pertains to you, I want you to receive it by fire, by force. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Because it's going to depend on your attitude. It's going to depend on how you grab the word of the Lord. That's going to determine whether you are going to change or not. Because if I am to give something to my brother does not have the thing unless he receives it. Hallelujah. Amen. Am I preaching?
Yes.
I've not even started yet. Thank you. In the name of Jesus. See, my brother, unless he receives it, he doesn't have it. You can receive something, but yes, you won't use it. Am I preaching? When you receive that thing, you can decide to go put that thing down, and the thing will remain there. Someone touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, I have the fire of God.
I have the fire.
Touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, I have the fire of God. Shout and say, devil, leave me alone. Leave me alone. For my boyfriend is the Lord. Come on, let me say, for my girlfriend is the Lord. He is my daddy. He is my father. He is my comforter. He is my helper. He is the one in all. He is my life. He is the way. He is the truth. He is the end. Clap your hands for Jesus.
Yeah.
Like I said, I didn't come here for you to be gentle to me, because I came here with fire. Not from IGM, Kadosh, but from heaven. Hallelujah. Amen. Matabala. I only have 30 minutes, and I've spent about 25 minutes. So I have 5 more. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bibles to Matthew chapter 6, verse 19. If you have a Bible, say, I have a Bible. If you don't have one, say, I don't have one. Okay. I'm going to assume everyone has a Bible. Hallelujah. Matama Yoshapa. Lekataka Badabadaba. Libre de Yiku Sabade. Limakatu Shubuho. Are you there? If you are there, say I'm there. Hallelujah. Ibakusa de Ibayada. And I read, do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But lay up yourselves treasures in what? In where?
Heaven.
In heaven. Talk to me, come on. In where?
Heaven.
In heaven. Where neither moth or rust destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You won't put something which is very important to you, or which is very important of yours. You will not put it in. Would you put it in your friend's house? Would you put it outside of your house? No. But where would you put it? Inside your house. Where? If it's very important. In your, she said in your closet. Bedroom. See, others will put theirs in a safe. But basically what Jesus Christ, what the Lord is saying here, is that don't sow a seed in a ground where the seed will not grow. Don't sow a seed in a ground where the seed will never grow. And when you sow a seed, make sure that the seed has deep roots. Where when someone, when the thief of the night, when the thief of the spirit comes to steal, comes to uproot your possession, they can never uproot it.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So don't store your treasure. Don't store what is very important to you. Where? Let me come down to your level. Hallelujah. See, in life, every step you move, you sow a seed. Am I preaching like I'm feeling?
That's right,
man. Every step you sow a seed. See, that's why some of our parents, you realize that the way they are, some of the children are like that. Am I preaching?
Yes.
Because as the father is living his life as he was young, the father was thinking of himself alone, but forgot that already his son or his child was already living in him through his blood. Hallelujah. So see, the blood is very, very important. See, that's why when you are living your life, in other words, you are giving your children an example to follow, but yet so your children are not here yet. When you are living a type of life, you are telling your children prophetically something, but your children are not here yet. So then you realize that you have done all these things, and your child grows up, and your child is doing the same thing, and you are telling your child to stop. Even if you wipe off blood, if you murder someone and you wipe off the blood, for some reason they can still come and detect that there is still blood there. That crimson stain, you can never erase it. The only way it can be erased is by the blood of the Maker. Someone shout hallelujah. That's the only way it can be erased. Amen. Verse 22. The eye is the what? It's the lamp of the body. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So if you are watching bad stuff, stop watching it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. I'll repeat again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The eye is what? It's the lamp of the body. Someone touch your name and tell them about stop sending those pictures.
Stop sending those pictures.
You know the pictures I'm talking about. So if your eye is what? Is healthy, your whole body is what? Will be full of what? Will be full of light. So meaning that you don't have to touch. Can I come to your level? You don't have to touch that girl. You don't have to touch that man. But just by looking at those naked pictures, your whole body is what? You are done. Funny how the Lord placed our light on our eyes. You can't be walking around while someone is doing something bad and you're walking around like this. Blind. You need your eye. Your eye gives you vision. Your eye tells you that, oh, I am to go here. If I go here, what? There's trouble. If I go here, there is no trouble. The eye causes you to be aware of what's ahead. So therefore, if your eye is off, you will fall anywhere. Am I preaching? You will fall anywhere. So someone will say that, oh, me watching porn, I'm better off than the one who is sleeping with another girl. You're lying.
Preach.
Let me tell you, the one who is sleeping with another girl is also seeing, right? And you watching porn, you haven't even slept yet. You're also seeing things. So therefore, both of you are in the same what? In the same what? Sin, not sin. There is no difference. Oh, I committed small sin. So therefore what? Tonight, I'm not only talking to the youthful. I'm talking to the old men and the old women, everyone. For the word of the Lord was not only made for children, but it was made for everyone. You'll be shocked how grown people in the church, married men and women, are even cheating. But they are still in the marriage. The man does not even know that the wife is cheating. Or cheating. Why are you quiet? The woman does not even know that the man is cheating. But 15 years still in the marriage, the man, the woman, they don't know. And in some marriages, both of them are cheating. Child, touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, child. Hey, both of them are cheating.
That's right.
You see, it's sin. You are doing this, it's sin. Your son is smoking weed, still sin. So now you understand why you are telling your son not to do something and your son doing it. Most of the time you talk and talk and talk, they'll still do. Because they don't need physical intervention. They need a spiritual and divine intervention. Clap for Jesus. They need a spiritual and divine intervention. So most of the time, what we have to do for ourselves, not only the good people, even the loved ones, is to pray for each other. You see that you go to a party and you see that your friend has stolen some girl. Don't go and start sharing the news. It's sad. It's a sad, whatever. It's sad. Have pity on them. When you go home, pray. Pray for yourself. Wake up early in the morning, 12 a.m., 1 a.m., 2 a.m. Pray just for that. Your friend who hates you in church. Your friend who hates you, not the one who loves you. The one who hates you in church. Pray. Starve yourself fast just for them. Because when one soul is saved, the whole of heaven rejoices. If you're on your phone, please get off your phone. It's an insult. If the Lord is speaking, give him your full attention. Hallelujah. Okay, so 22. The eye is the lamp of the body. So if your eye is healthy, your whole body is what? Will be full of light. It not even say that the whole body will be healthy. So just your eye. Your whole body will be full of light. It gets to a point where when your whole body is full of light, you become light. When people see you, they don't see you. They say, who is this light? I prophesy tonight, huh, that your name will change from COVID, from John, from Anna, to a mysterious one. When people see you, all those things, hey,
hallelujah.
That's your name.
Amen.
I receive that. A new name.
23. But if your eye is bad, the whole body will be full of what? Darkness. Meaning that if your eye is bad, you are the devil. Am I preaching?
Yes.
And the devil is full of darkness. So you and him, there's no difference. So don't take it as an insult when someone tells you. 24. No one can serve what? Two masters. For either he will hate one, the one, and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You cannot serve God and what?
Money.
Take one. See, sometimes when you say people don't understand, you start asking you questions. They want you to go to church and behind me, what will pay my bills for me? It's an insult. Who provides for you? Isn't it the Lord? No, I'm not saying that sit at home, put your hands in between your lap and wait for money to fall from heaven. It will never fall. Obviously, you're going to do what? You're going to work. But basically, see, that's what the word of God, you need the spirit of understanding to understand.
That's right.
You can't just go with your body like that and start reading. See, that's what people say. say, I read the Bible, I don't understand.
That's right.
Because you're reading the Bible with your physical mind, not your spiritual mind.
Preach to me.
Ah.
Praise the Lord.
So therefore, love the Lord. Make the Lord number one. The way you will work for money, eh? Work for God like that.
Amen.
Monday, 8 hours. Tuesday, what? 8 hours. Wednesday, what? 8 hours. All week, 40. But when it comes to God, Sunday, 2 hours. Even the 2 hours when the man of God is preaching, it's disturbing.
We come late.
Let's go to John chapter 8. I'll be done very soon. Yeah. John chapter 8. Is the Lord even talking at all in here?
Yes.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. John chapter 8, verse 12. Are you reading?
That's right.
Okay. I want you to be there before I get there. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in what? In darkness. But will have the light of what?
Life.
Of life. You see how easy that is? That sounds. He said that I am the light of where? The world. If anyone should just imitate me, do photocopy. Not original. Heal. I preach. You don't have to be a good preacher. Just preach. Don't care about the crowds.
It's not your word.
Preach. You have been sent to give someone a message. My master says that come and see me and pay your tithes. Then you're done with you. But some people don't go. My master said give me money. When you're done, come and pay your tithes. What I did, do the same thing. For the word of the Lord says that as the Father, Jesus Christ said, as the Father has loved, so have I loved. Now you remain in that love. Meaning that you stay there, don't go anywhere. But it's only in this generation, love of the Lord is like poison to them. The love of the Lord is like poison. You said someone come to church Sunday, you have destroyed their life. But you say go to party and turn up to 3 a.m. and you have blessed them with the whole world. You have saved their life. You see how that's sad? That's very, very, very sad. It has even gotten to a point where the parents can't even say anything anymore. Because they are doing it with their physical strength. But when you rely on the Most High God,
amen.
No prayer.
Amen. Jesus.
See, the reason why some people, their prayers are not answered. Number one, you are depending on man too much. The Lord said, just me and you. Let's have this relationship. But you want to see God with your physical eye. So you have made your man of God what?
God.
Don't wait to come to church on Sunday and come start dancing around, roaming around the sanctuary. But when you are home, eh? When you are home, just you. Because you know. See, your God is not a physical God. He is spirit. So in order for you to see God, you have to tap into the spirit to see God.
Yes.
You can't be in your flesh and say, Father, I've prayed that 10 years now, I haven't seen you yet. Me, John, who is no one, but has been made someone. Me, I've seen God before. So if I'm telling someone, and me, I know what I saw. I can't prove to you because me, I can't describe what I saw. But you see, when you live that life, When you want to become like Christ, because Christ has seen his Father before. Because so when you want to become like Christ, you will eventually be molded and you become like him. For the Bible says that we are joint heirs with Christ. So meaning that you and Christ, you are twins. Whatever belongs to Christ in the kingdom of heaven exactly belongs to you. If in the kingdom of heaven, God has 10 cars in the name of Jesus, he's not saying that Jesus will have 5. You have 5. He said that same 10 belongs to you.
Amen.
So meaning that in the access of God the Father, Jesus Christ is to sit on the throne. If Jesus Christ is not there, who's sitting there?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey, where was I? But who have the light of life. 13. So the Pharisees said to him, "You are bearing witness about yourself. Your testimony is not what? It's not true." 14. Jesus answered, "Even if I do bear witness about myself, my testimony is what? It's true." See, sometimes you go and stand somewhere and you tell someone about God, they start asking you questions. You start preaching, they start asking you questions. I can preach and tell you that me, I'm God. You won't believe. But it's in the Bible. See, Jesus Christ was saying that even if I am not God, indeed I am the Son of God, you cannot take that away from me. So even if I am not speaking of my Father who is in heaven, and I'm speaking about myself, I'm not even lying to you guys. I'm saying the truth. Even if I bear witness about myself, the testimony that I bear is what? It's true. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give the Lord a mighty shout.
Amen.
Is the Lord even speaking?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, I'll skip steps a little bit. I don't want to waste your time. Matthew chapter 5. And this is where I end. Matthew chapter 5, verse 13 to 16. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now, when we read before, Jesus Christ said something. He said, "I am the what? I am the what? He is the light of the world." Now we'll see something somewhere. Matthew chapter 5. Is it verse 13?
Yes.
Verse 13. The word of the Lord says that you are the salt of the what? Of the earth. Meaning that you are what preserves what? The earth. You are what gives the earth what? A purpose. You are what gives the earth a meaning. Without you, the earth is incomplete. If there is something wrong with this earth, if this earth is to go back, he said that you can save the world. You can save the world from going back. So now you know the power you have. It's not that this is not a time where, "Hey, Father, give me power, give me power, give me the one I want." You already have it. Once, honestly speaking, once you have accepted Christ, that's what people don't know. Once you have accepted Christ, you have it. It's just that it is not, it's not like boiling water. Even boiling water, some people find it very difficult. It's not that easy. But he makes it easy because he does it through you. Am I preaching?
Yes.
Yes. So therefore, if you are praying, you pray today, it's not being answered. Who told you? Who told you? For the Father already knoweth what you ask for. He already knows. He wants you to exercise that power. He wants you to become like him. Because the Lord is not a lazy God. You think he's just sitting on the throne there, not doing anything. So therefore, he doesn't bring up his children to be what? To be lazy. You pray, you pray, you pray, you fast. And you have to know whether you see it with your eye or not, it's answered. Boom.
Amen.
Just move on with your life.
That's right.
But some people will pray for just that one thing for 10 years. 10 good years. If you have a migraine, let me give an example. If you have a migraine and you are taking ibuprofen and the migraine is not going, would you still keep taking ibuprofen? You need a medication for what? For migraine. That's the same way with prayer. When you are praying about that one thing, it's not that it's not being answered. Maybe there's an obstacle. There is something. God has already sent an angel to deliver your blessing, to come and deliver your son, to come and deliver your daughter.
Amen.
But there is something there. That's what the word of the Lord says, that for we do not wrestle against what?
Flesh
and blood. In other words, this life that we are in, the struggle that we are struggling, it is not a physical struggle. We are not struggling with ourselves. Instead of you loving your neighbor, you are hating your neighbor. You are fighting against your own neighbor. But he said that this struggle is against principalities. The reason why the neighbor is fighting with you is because the neighbor is seeing the light in you. And the darkness in your neighbor does not like the light in you. So therefore, you don't do what? It is not you fighting. Spirits are fighting through you.
Amen.
So you are the salt of what? Of the earth. You give this earth a meaning. You give this earth a purpose. You preserve this earth. You are the authoritative figure. You are the power. You are the dominion. In the name of Jesus, you are the dominion of this earth. You have been made to take absolute control. So if you are being afflicted, don't sit there for affliction to bully you, because you are God over affliction.
That's right.
You are mighty. You are powerful.
Amen.
You are like God himself.
Hallelujah.
The fact that you have a flesh does not mean that you are not powerful. The Lord is to open your eye. You say, Father, close. You are very, very strong. Can you even comprehend or digest this? How angels, they serve the Lord. They are serving the Lord. But for some reason, they are also serving you.
Yes.
Ask yourself, who is serving them? Ask yourself, who is serving the angels? But the same servants of the Lord are also serving you.
Amen.
So you are in the same house with the Lord.
That's right.
It's either you are the Lord's cousin, you are the Lord's brother, you are the Lord's sister, you are the Lord's father, mother, but it's as though you have the same blood with the one. You see, when the enemy touches you, they have touched the Lord. Am I preaching? Like I'm feeling it. When the enemy touches the Lord, they have touched you. That's your relationship with what? With God. You guys are one. He said, you live in me. Not just that one. And me live in you. You cannot do anything if he doesn't live in you and you don't live in him. It's like getting married. So you guys become one. You guys are one. No one can separate you. So if your husband is feeling sad, you the wife, how do you feel? Do you feel happy? If things are not going on in the house and your husband is worried and he doesn't have a job, how does the wife feel? So when they touch you, they have touched the Lord. But you see, sometimes it depends on you. You have to give the Lord the permission to do what he has to do. That's why you don't just say that, oh, I have accepted Jesus Christ as my person, that's it. He said, you have to believe. You. He's not saying, I will believe for you. He's not going to believe for you. He said, you believe. He said, I am at the door knocking. If anyone, whosoever opens the door, he said, I will come into them with him. I will have an intimate time. I will shut up. I will come in to have an intimate relationship with him. And he will come to dine with me. If you have that relationship with Christ, he will come into you, into that temple. And he will have a very great relationship with you. He will teach you how to be like God. Then when you go there, you will also enjoy with him. It works hand in hand. You're like, Father Lord, bless me. Father, give me money. But my question to you, is that what are you giving to God? When ask Hannah, she will tell you. What are you giving to Lord, the Lord? Sometimes the Lord is just testing you. He just wants you to open up your heart. But you know, the Lord is so wise. Even if you are lying, he knows. So you can't just go and stand there and say, Father, give me this, I'll give it to you. Then when the Lord gives it to you, you run away. You run away, becomes a curse to you. I continue. He says, you are the earth of what? Of you are the salt of the earth. He said, if the salt should lose its taste, if you should lose your identity in Christ, if you should lose your purpose in Christ, if you should lose what makes you the son of God, he said, how can its saltness be restored? If you lose your calling, if you lose your divine purpose, basically what he's saying is that you are doomed. But see, you can't do it alone. That's why he said, when I go, I will tell my Father to send you what? I will tell my Father to send you another paracletos. Meaning, I will tell my Father to send you another helper. When someone is a helper to you, it's your strength at your weakness. Not just that, it also becomes your weakness at your strength. Now, what do I mean by your weakness at your strength? Meaning that if you are strong in doing what is bad, if you are strong in doing the things of this world, it makes you weak to those things. He helps you both ways. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then he went ahead. You see, we read before, Jesus Christ said what? I think I have to read. Jesus Christ said, I am the what? I am the light of the world. The world. But keep reading. Matthew chapter 5. Keep reading. He said that you are what? You are the light of the world. Now when I read that, I was confused. I said, If you are Oga, all of a sudden you turn around and you said, me too, I am Oga. See, when Igwe is walking around, when they see Igwe, what do they do? Igwe. When Igwe's son is going, what do they do? Igwe's son. You're also Igwe. They say Igwe's what? Son. Because you have the last name of what? Igwe. Tonight I prophesy to you, as you have the last name of the Lord, your name will change her to John Christ. Your name will change to Emmanuel Christ. Your name will change from Grace Christ. Your name will change from Christ Charles Christ. Your name will change from Generation Christ. Your name will change from you, Christ. Because you have the last name of what?
Of Christ.
Grace Christ. Hallelujah. So, why am I saying all these things? Listen, if you come from Christ, you are of Christ, you have his last name, you share in the same things with him, then you
like him. You should behave like him. You should act like him. Watching porn would help you. Lying won't help you. Stealing won't help you. When your mother talk, you talk back.
Don't worry, you give birth some.
Now, honestly, I'm not a woman. I have not bared a child before. But just by watching it on YouTube, watching it on those movies, child. Honestly speaking, if your mother could hold you for 9 months, I was watching this show, Grey's Anatomy, and this woman was pregnant, and she was about to give birth, she was in labor, and I think something happened. Instead of the child coming with the head first, the child was coming with the leg first, and this lady said that, you know what? If you go into the ER and something goes wrong, save my child. Tonight, that's what Jesus Christ is saying. He said, Father Lord, my God who is in heaven, who sent me? As I am going to die on the cross, if anything should happen to me, save my people.
Amen.
He died a death. You and I, we can't die. He did resurrection that we cannot even do. Just so that when he did that, it does not mean that automatically you just have billions and billions in your account. It means that he has given you that key to have access to it. So if someone has given you his key or his passcode to a safe in a bank that has billions and billions of money, what do you do with the key? You go and open. Use what Christ has given you. He has given you the access. Take it by fire, by force.
Amen.
For the weapons of our what? Warfare are not what? They are used for doing what? Pulling down what? Walls. You use it. Don't say that I am a Christian. Christian, the word has Christ and IAN. IAN means to be like. To be like Christ. So don't go and do whatever outside and come to church and who do you think you're lying to? When the same God saw you outside, you are lying to yourself. See, I did not come here to come and, excuse me, insult you. Or to come and speak harshly to you. But I came here to tell you or to redirect you and tell you that the light is here. Where you are going, no light. Where you are going, danger. See, I lost one of my youth. Few months ago. Listen, when you die, now you're not coming back home. So the life you are living, live it well. Don't stand there and say, you are not dying. You don't even know when you die. The righteous, the holy, the unrighteous, unholy, both have one thing in common, death. You will all die. But you see, when you die, no point of return. No point of return. So if you are living a type of life, live it well. Because your children will come and live. See, your parents will tell you, you listen, but your parents don't go, right? Your parents will go, and you'll be moving from pastor to pastor. Give me oil, give me water. Let's mix the oil and the water. For double. Oh, yeah, clap for Jesus.
Homozygous mixture.
Don't put them mixing stuff. Shall we be on our feet?